Let's go to Dunedin. It's experiment with the Green Party mayor is over. Aaron Hawkins losing the role after just one term. Didn't put his name in the hat for council either. Dunedin Mayor-elect Jules Radich is here with us live. Congratulations, Mayor Radich. How are you feeling this morning?
Really good, thanks, John. Very good.
Why did people vote
That's
for
rather
you?
Elated, but yeah, I'm very not calm facing the storm.
I'm not surprised you're elated. What is it you think people were voting for in Dunedin?
Well, largely for change. You know, the people of Dunedin feel that they haven't been listened to over the last 3 years, and so they were very keen to have a change.
And a change to what? What is it that people are hoping for from this change?
Well, I believe they want active participation in our democracy, so they want their voice to be heard and taken heed of.
And how does that happen? How does that happen at a local government level?
Well, I suppose our campaign with Team Dunedin has been instructive in that regard. So we formed up about a year ago, and then we spent the last 4 months going out to market days and other venues where there were lots of people and talking to them, hearing their opinions about things and discussing our thoughts and ideas with them, which firmed up our policies and agenda.
I want to talk about some of the water issues there in South Dunedin, just getting that water out of South Dunedin when it rains heavily. There is an infrastructure deficit in Dunedin that's going to cost a lot of money. Can you do it? Do you have the money to do it?
Yes, I believe so. And that is a high priority for me. I live in South Dunedin, so I'm very concerned about the threat of inundation from stormwater. And I think we need to do more and do it more rapidly in order to protect the residents from that threat, but also to give them confidence in their real estate, in their houses and where they live, but also the businesses that are thinking or would like to develop in the area, to give them confidence that the area is going to be safe.
Is three waters the answer?
And I take the example of Holland, which is 60% under.
Is three waters the answer, do you think?
Yes, three waters. I don't think so because people do not want to lose control or ownership of their assets. And that's a really significant issue. I mean, there's two big issues with three waters, but ownership of the assets is critically important to people. And I don't think there's any need to transfer ownership away. Administration can move to a larger organisation to achieve economies of scale, whilst the local communities still retain ownership of the assets beneath their feet.
It's interesting this, isn't it? Because, Three Waters hasn't had a great morning on Q&A. I mean, we haven't stumbled upon many fans of it. But I would say that successive local governments, successive councils haven't done a great job of managing the water infrastructure in Dunedin. In fact, if people will forgive me using this term on a Sunday morning, although it may be apt considering wastewater is part of it, they've done a piss poor job. Isn't there an opportunity for you to get something from government here to fix the broken?
Well, it won't come from government. The ratepayers are still going to pay for all of that extra development, one way or another. Just by transferring three waters to a different entity, the price will go up, no matter who's running it. So I don't see that is the answer. And I'm really concerned that the more centralised authority becomes over three waters, the less responsive they will be to the needs of Dunedin in a crisis. And we have had a crisis, and in fact we've had two crises in the last 3 years.
Yeah.
So I'm very concerned about that.
Well, it's a beautiful city.
So, I take issue with what you're saying about doing a piss poor job. I think our fresh water is in really good shape. We're double A. So our water supply has been well looked after and brought up. So sure, there's some little patchy bits in the outskirts, but our main water supply is in really good shape. We have a wonderful catchment that we have full control of, so we're good there. And our wastewater treatment plant is up to a high standard, and so we have made significant gains there over the recent time. But it's our stormwater that needs to be taken care of next, and then we'll start the cycle all again. So we are on track to be constantly upgrading our three waters infrastructure. And I think the plan that we have within council is perfectly sufficient.
Jules Radich, we really wish you well over the next 3 years. It's a beautiful city. And thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
And congratulations on being Dunedin Mayor-elect. Thanks for being with us this morning.